Found hand sanitizer. Been needing that. Feel like I'm less than 6 feet from this camera lens, so I need to make sure I'm all sanitized up. Let's take a survey. How many of you right now are wearing the exact same outfit that you wore yesterday because you're quarantined in your house? I wore this sweatshirt for yesterday's video that I filmed. Anyway, today we're talking about puffy jackets, the three-season jacket, and just the things that I think you should really look for when you purchase one. I'm not gonna tell you what to do. I'm just gonna give you sort of that overview like I try to do a lot of times on this channel, just to give you some thoughts and perspective based on my experience of what I've purchased, and hopefully we'll give you guys an opportunity to figure it out on your own. I've got, I think, six puffy jackets to show you guys. I've got four brands represented, from expensive to, I've got a decently budget jacket here as well. And also, before I get too far in the video, I wanna thank the sponsor of today's video, Backcountry. So Backcountry, thank you for sponsoring the video. Also, I wanna say a huge thank you to many of you who hit that subscribe button the other day when I posted a video, and many of you watch but aren't subscribed. So I am coming up on that 50,000 subscriber mark. I'm extremely excited about it. And so if you wanna help me get there, this is sort of the one and only times I'm gonna beg and plead like a big baby to get subscribers. I normally don't do stuff like this, and I don't like it. I think it's kind of pathetic when people do it, but here I am, I'm doing it. But that's okay, it's a big deal. So make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed already. So I think there's kind of three major things that pretty much everybody looks at when they're looking for their down jacket or their puffy jacket or whatever it is that they're purchasing to keep themselves warm. They wanna know, is it packable? They wanna know, is it lightweight? And they wanna know, is it gonna keep them warm? But beyond that, it's really just additional bells and whistles, I guess. And if you can get a jacket to do those three things, you're already like way ahead of the game. All right, let's talk about like features that a jacket could have. Hoods versus no hoods, and pockets versus no pockets, and a completely zip-up jacket versus like a pullover jacket. So every one of my jackets is a complete zip-up jacket. Every one of my jackets has pockets, but three of the six jackets that I've got here have hoods and the other three don't. Why do I have half of my jackets that don't have hoods? Well, because sometimes I like a hood and sometimes I don't. Here's the reason I don't like a hood. This is the Mountain Hardware Ghost Whisperer. This was the first puffy jacket that I ever bought for backpacking when I was getting into backpacking. It's a great jacket, and it's probably the most popular jacket that you'll see out there. This might seem a little bit picky, but it's something that bothers me. So like when I'm wearing a hood like this, if I want to turn my head, the hood stays pretty much in one spot and I can only see out of one eye, all right? I have to turn my whole body like this in order to see out of a hood. It kind of drives me nuts. What I do in those situations is I actually just bring like a neck gaiter that I can sort of fashion into a hat or a beanie, or I just bring a lightweight hat with me. Now, some guys care about this. It doesn't really bother me too much, but a hood does add, you know, additional weight to a jacket, but it is convenient. It's definitely convenient to have a hood. It's just there. You can throw it on when it gets really cold. It keeps your neck warm. You can sleep with a hood on, that kind of stuff. So it really is helpful in certain situations. Another thing you want to consider is, are you going to buy a down jacket, you know, like with feathers in it, or are you going to buy a synthetic jacket, which is a jacket that has man-made insulation? And there's benefits to both. A down jacket is typically going to be much more packable, so it can kind of compress really small, and it's going to be very, very lightweight. It's about as lightweight as you can get for a jacket. Whereas a synthetic jacket is not going to be as packable, and it's definitely going to be heavier. So why would I buy a synthetic over a down jacket? Well, a synthetic jacket resists moisture in most situations. So if it gets wet, it's still gonna have those insulating values. It's still gonna be able to loft up. It's still gonna be able to be nice and thick to hold in the warmth. Whereas a down jacket, when it gets wet, those feathers pretty much become useless and it doesn't provide warmth any longer. Let me show you a cool feature that I use quite a bit when I am shopping and trying to figure out what would be the best option for me based on, you know, just a lot of criteria that I think about when I'm shopping. I'll go to Backcountry's website and I like to click on shop. And then let's say I want to look for a down jacket. So I'll go to men's jackets, and maybe I want to look for just a down jacket. So I'll scroll down to the more filters tab. I'll go down to insulation and I will select downfill. Now here's what's really cool. So Now you can see it pulls up all of the down jackets. You can click on more, lowest price. And now I can see that the lowest price option is this Columbia jacket for $60. So there you go. You just found yourself a budget down jacket. Now let's say you want to find out more about that jacket. You go up to the chat feature here and it will pull up this little window here where you can type in your name and you could talk to one of the gearheads. And the gearheads are cool because these guys are actually former Olympians, they're former athletes, and they're former trail guides. So they definitely have experience that can at least, at the very least, point you in the right direction. If you want to buy any of these jackets at Backcountry, they did give me a coupon code for 15% off. Some exclusions do apply. The coupon code is Dan15. So you can go ahead and put that in the checkout and get that 15%. Okay, so I have two synthetic jackets that I own. First is the Patagonia Micro Puff. This is the one without a hood. This is extremely lightweight and it's actually really, really warm. So the warmth to weight ratio is phenomenal. And Patagonia somehow created like this insulation that makes it almost act like down. It's not totally like down. I mean, it doesn't compress as well, but it's pretty close. And if I handed this to one of you guys and asked you if it was a down jacket or a synthetic jacket, I bet you a lot of people couldn't tell the difference. The other synthetic I have is a jacket that's a little bit warmer, but it's also a little bit heavier. It is by Arc'teryx, and it is the Arc'teryx Atom LT. This one does have a hood on it, and I've used this one in very, very cold temperatures down into below freezing weather with just a t-shirt on, and it's been a little bit chilly, but not bad. It's definitely warmer than the Patagonia, but it's also, I think, like 5 or 6 ounces heavier, but it's not as packable either. It's just a very quality, nice, lightweight-ish jacket for the backcountry. The most lightweight jacket that I own, and it is still a fairly warm jacket. It's about as warm as my Mountain Hardwear Ghost Whisperer is this one. This is the Arc'teryx Cerium SL, and this one does not have a hood, but as far as I'm aware, this is the lightest full-featured jacket on the market, and it is really packable, and it's made with 850 down. Let's talk about that real quick. What does the numbers mean on down? So you're gonna hear that pretty often. You're gonna go to a store and it's gonna say like 600 downfill or 650 downfill or 800 downfill. The number on the down doesn't mean that it's gonna be a warmer jacket. It just means that the feather inside the jacket is a puffier feather, the larger the number. So a 800 fill feather is gonna be a very puffy feather, and a 600 fill jacket is gonna be a very small puffy feather. And why that's important is because when you have a jacket with a higher fill power, it takes less feathers to fill it up. Therefore, the jacket is gonna be lighter. So a 600 fill jacket is probably gonna be as warm as an 850 or a 900 fill jacket, but the 600 fill jacket is gonna be quite a bit heavier. Now the higher the down power, you're typically gonna pay a premium for. So just take that into consideration as well. Some of these jackets have a 700 fill and others have up to 850. So like for instance, this Mountain Hardwear that I just showed you is an 800 fill down jacket. This Arc'teryx jacket is a 850 fill jacket, and the budget option that I have to show you is actually a hoodless version as well. This is the Marmot Azos. This one is a 700 fill jacket. It weighs a little bit more, but it's a down jacket, and it's actually warmer than the other ones because I think it's got more feathers in it overall, and it's really a great jacket. I have no complaints about this jacket whatsoever. So if you're looking to save a couple bucks, definitely look at buying this jacket. Now the warmest jacket that I have, that's also the lightest for its warmth, is this jacket right here. But this is an expensive jacket. This is the Arc'teryx Cerium SL. This is definitely a pricey jacket, but in my opinion, this is worth every penny for me because I go backpacking so often. And this is more of a winter style backpacking jacket, and I backpack almost monthly in the winter. And I have had this jacket down to about 10 degrees with just a t-shirt on and been completely fine. And it packs down extremely small. Now the downside to wearing this jacket is that it's so expensive and so nice that when I sit around a fire, I don't want like embers landing on it and burning it, because this is like the jacket that I also wear around the town in the winter too. So how I stop that is I will take like a hard shell, a cheap hard shell, like the Frog Togs rain jacket or something, some jacket that I could just totally care less about, and I'll wear that over the top of my expensive jackets, so I don't have to worry about it. Now here's a pro tip for you guys. Let's say you're hiking in colder temperatures, but it's gonna fluctuate temperatures. So like maybe during the daytime, it could get into the 40s or 50s, but at nighttime, it's gonna dip down to the 20s or the teens. And you wanna make sure that you're warm and comfortable in both situations. Well, what you can do is you can actually bring two lightweight jackets and just layer them. And that way you've got a lot more ability to regulate your temperatures. So when you're hiking, for instance, you could just peel off one jacket or the other jacket. And at nighttime, you've got two lightweight down jackets to keep yourself warm into the lower temperatures. So to sum it all up for you, really, it depends on where you live, what your adventures are like, what your backcountry experiences are like, and what you're planning on doing. But what it comes down to for me is I wanna make sure it's packable, I wanna make sure it's lightweight, and I wanna make sure it's warm. I can deal with down versus synthetic by adding a layer over the top and protecting it. And I can deal with the hood versus no hood because I can bring a beanie, or I can just leave the beanie at home and bring one of my hooded jackets. So hopefully this video helps you guys out. If it does, give me a thumbs up. Also, subscribe for more. Hit the bell notification so I can send you a video every time it's released. And I will see you on the next one.